Hey you guys, welcome or welcome back to Journeys with Jay. In today's video, I will be showing you all how I properly prep my nail beds for nail application. This will work for poly gel, dip, gel X nails, or gel extensions, as well as acrylic if that's what you choose to wear. First, I'm starting off with my cuticle remover. I get it from this brand. You can get this on Amazon. I will be sure to have that link below. I would highly recommend following the instructions to a T that comes on the packaging for usage. I'm applying that to each of my cuticles and allowing that to sit for about 10 to 15 seconds. Next, I will be going in with a silicone cuticle pusher. These are much more gentle than the metal ones because that can actually scrape up layers of the nail plate. We don't want to do that. So what I'm doing is just going around that cuticle, working in that cuticle remover, and I'm starting to slowly push back that cuticle. Next, I'm using the opposite end of my cuticle pusher to really remove that skin from being connected to my nail bed. This really helps for me to get in there because I find that a lot of times when you just push the cuticle back and you don't go underneath that cuticle skin, you will still have a lot of that attached to your nail plate. And now I'm going to go in with the metal one just to use that opposite end to really make sure that all of that skin is lifted. This one's a bit more aggressive, so just be mindful, take your time, and really get that skin lifted off of the nail. Thank you. Next, I'm going in with my cuticle nippers, and you'll see me pulling the skin back just so that I'm able to easily see what needs to be clipped off as far as dead skin. Please take your time with this part, and this is why we go in beforehand with both the silicone and the metal cuticle pusher, because lifting that skin is so important so that it's easily accessible and that way it's easier to clip off. Please, please, please take your time with this part, you guys. I can't tell you how many times I've clipped my cuticle. It is not ideal, okay? It's not good at all. As you all can see right here, I have a little bit of stubborn skin that didn't want to come up, and so I'm just kind of scraping away until it lifts. Don't do this, please, please don't do this, especially if you're really new to, you know, using cuticle nippers and just your nails overall. Go back to the cuticle pusher and continue to lift up any skin that you want lifted off of your nail bed, okay? And we're just repeating again that process for the rest of my fingers. Next, I'm going in with my ball drill bit. This is my favorite drill bit that I love to use for all of the dead skin around my nails, as well as the cuticles. And you see how this just removes any additional dead skin that we don't want there. And this is going directly against the skin, you guys. I'm not dragging this along my nail bed or anything. I'm only pressing this into the actual cuticle, making sure not to put this down onto the nail. Thank you. because I choose not to use a drill directly on my nail bed, especially when prepping. I like to go in with either a 100 over 180 nail file or 180 over 240, whichever, you know, both of them work just fine. The 180 over 100 is just a little bit more coarse, and that works just fine for me. So I just like to go in and lightly buff the surface of the nails, roughing them up, and this just makes for really good adhesion. Make sure when you're doing this step, you're filing every bit of the nail. Make sure that you don't have any shine left behind. You're getting against the sidewalls, the free edge, and back towards that cuticle area so that the whole nail is roughed up. I know that a lot of you guys were stating that your nails have thinned out, you're going in with the drill bit, and now your nail beds are super thin and fragile. This will just be a good step for you guys to utilize instead of that drill, because I'm really big on not using a drill directly on my natural nail bed. I personally remove any nail growth before a new set, so here I'm just making sure that my nails are filed all the way down and that my free edge is nice and clean and smooth. I'm just brushing off any dust that I have on my nails as well as my gloves. This is one of my lint-free wipes with some acetone, and I'm really wiping every bit of the nail, removing any dust, you know, going around those cuticles. This is really going to dry that nail all the way out. As you guys can see, I did have some new cuticle nippers and they did get me 2 times, but that's okay. Next, I'm going in with my Model 1's Nail Prep Dehydrator, and I'm just going to be painting that on all of the nails. Thank you. So that is how I properly prep my nails for any nail set that I have coming up. I do this each time, and this helps with the longevity. Even if I'm putting on a peel-off base coat, I make sure that I still follow my same prep. It has really nice clean cuticles, and it helps you to maintain a nice natural nail bed in between your nail sets as well. I'll see you guys in the next one. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Ciao.